say thank yous at the end, but I just wanted to come up in the beginning and tell you thank you, because sometimes with our event, people will come in the morning and then we'll have a whole new crowd in the afternoon. And so I want to make sure that the people are here in the morning that we just tell you thank you. And so without further ado, we'll have Nana come up from the Nana Show as our wonderful mistress of ceremony. Thank you.
Thank you so very much. You know, sometimes people don't understand what it takes to put something like this on. Dr. Sherri, let's come and give her a round of applause, please. Sometimes I get a chance to talk with her, and she's like, I gotta get this done. You all look so good. Oh my goodness, give your hand, for so as I can. Okay, so I have to let you know, I'm about energy. You cannot, like, not have, talking to me is like, when people are on my talk, it's called Talking to Now, I'm on AM 1200 WCHB, and I'm not gonna be long with you. People feel, it's like having a cup of coffee, because it's like, hey, everybody. It's just, I believe in good energy. I love life. I'm grateful to be alive, and I'm grateful to be connected to wonderful people. I'm gonna get started. Are you ready?
Yes.
Wonderful. So we're at the annual Michigan Trade Summit here in the city of Detroit, and it talks all over the world. Again, my name is NanaDansoa, talking with Nana Show on AM Health, 1200 WCHB, and we're going to be expanding very soon. So we're gonna start with our opening remarks from the state of Michigan, MEDC, Tupac Hunter of Wayne County. I'm gonna bring him up here very soon. Come on. Now I have to say this, when I see his face, you know what comes to mind? He's been with our holidays, he's been with our family holidays, because I would get things in the mail from Mr. Tupac when he remembers it, and we appreciate it. Come on up and have your remarks, please.
Thank you so much. First of all, let me say that I used to think until this morning that I had the coolest name ever until I met I can't say the whole name, but it just sounds so pretty to me. Thank you so much for welcoming me here this morning, and to Dr. Henderson for inviting me to just bring some brief welcoming remarks on behalf of Wayne County Executive Warren Evans. As you all know, first of all, again, welcome to the beautiful Garvey Building. You couldn't have picked a better place in downtown Detroit. And of course, this is the seat of Wayne County government. The Wayne County Executive would want me to, by way of a brief update, let you know where we are as your county government. I have good news, and perhaps you've heard, but I don't get tired of repeating that 2 years ago, when Mr. Evans took over as the new county executive, we found ourselves on the verge of bankruptcy or emergency management. His team that he assembled got to work very quickly, and 2 years, well, 2 years and a few months later, we are in the black, 2 years straight of budget surplus. Thank you very much for that. Credit rating that's positive and improving, as well as a newfound optimism in Wayne County government. And nothing but upside, nothing but opportunity moving forward. So as we look at what it took to get us here by eliminating our structural deficit there, as well as our accumulated deficit, making the sacrifices that needed to be made, that's good, but it only could get us so far. Now it's time to really focus our efforts on continuing to grow our economy here in Wayne County. So to do that, we're focused on the advantages that we have, our prime location. As business people, I don't need to tell you about that. Location is key. Our strong economic base. We are a burgeoning powerhouse we've always been strong in the automotive sector, as you know, but on the logistics side, the IT side, advanced manufacturing, we are poised to be, continue to be, an economic powerhouse in that regard. A very strong infrastructure system. This is the Michigan Trade Summit, so you all are very familiar with the aspects of what a strong infrastructure system means, what a world-class airport able to ship 400 plus million pounds of cargo a year, what that means. Being home to four Class 1 railroads, two of which are intercontinental, what that means in terms of opportunity. And last but not least, the talent assets that we have in this area with our strong colleges and universities, with how our universities are producing the greatest talent in the world in the STEM fields. These are all things that we should be proud of and things that we should take advantage of. So what's our strategy for economic development here in Wayne County? Well, first, the CEO is really big on collaboration and cooperation with our local communities and with our partners. So I'm glad to be here today to start a relationship and maintain a relationship with your organization to provide whatever support and assistance we can on behalf of Wayne County to help you in the businesses that you represent be successful in this area. We also are very focused on helping our businesses start, build, and grow here in Wayne County. We have a new partnership with the Small Business Development Center, as well as others, where we are counseling businesses that are at various stages. We are looking to leverage the resources we have in the way of capital financing and other things to assist businesses in those vital areas. Also, business retention is a key priority for us. We know that 80% of all new jobs that will be created in this local economy will be created by businesses that are represented in this room. So we want you to know that we are here, we're supportive, and again, we want to do all that we can to make sure that you're successful and thriving here in our great county. And last but not least, I just wanted to say that, unfortunately, I can't stay for the whole event. I'm going to try to make it back up so I can network with you, but we're definitely here to help again. So through, I'm not sure what the appropriate protocol should be, but I'll just appoint Dr. Henderson as my contact to you all. So if you ever need any assistance, if you would like any information about our available programs and services, please don't hesitate to call on us. We'll be here for you. Thank you so very much and have a good day.
Very much. We appreciate you. Next, coming to the stage, we'd like to bring in someone who I had a wonderful opportunity of meeting. She is a very distinguished woman in her profession. What I love also is that she represents the Michigan Black Chamber of Commerce very well. So thank you all. I want you all to welcome to Allison stage, Ms. Ivy Simmons.
Thank you, Dana. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Ooh, much more. So I am here representing Michigan Black Chamber of Commerce, but first I must begin by saying thank you to Nana, who is a wonderful host here in the city. She broadcasts across our airwaves. And Dr. Sherri Henderson, who was formerly the president of our Lansing chapter. The Michigan Black Chamber of Commerce is in its 6th year of operation. We are a young organization, but we are the largest Black Chamber across the country with 3,200 members. We are fortunate to have over 46,000 businesses registered in the city of Detroit and over 100,000 in the state of Michigan. We are looking forward to have our first membership campaign this year and broadening our scope and scale so that we can assist businesses. The luck and fortune of being in Michigan is that we host over 26 businesses that on every year CRB 100s. And these businesses are, the wonderful Bridgewater, we have the James Group who was honored last year. These businesses are multinational. And our role in the Michigan Black Chamber of Commerce is to increase those businesses that are that can rise to the capacity, scope, and scale of the James Group and Bridgewater organizations. So we are happy to be here, and we are pleased to support this endeavor ongoingly. This is just the second year, and we look forward to this happening for many, many years to come. We are partners in this work. We work steadfastly with small businesses and larger businesses, partnering them, offering opportunities for procurement with municipalities and with our corporate partners. So we look forward to working with you all and being here. Have a wonderful day.
Wow, what a wonderful organization. When I hear her talk about that, it's like, wow, we have that in the city of Detroit? That is amazing. That's just amazing. You all are making history in so many different ways. And the gentleman who's filming right now is going to be up. And if he's working, he has to make sure he makes a transaction
first, you know, and then you can continue on. Ladies and gentlemen, I met this gentleman 20 years ago. I still believe I'm 21, so I don't know how that magically happened. So I met him 20 years ago when we both had this vision of doing some great work in the city of Detroit. And one of the things I love about that, when you look at your childhood, so I'm gonna say child so I can throw people off of being 21 when I eventually get a magical age and I get rich. When we look at that in the past, we look at the future, that we're doing exactly what we want to do, change Detroit through our own way and doing positive things with our ethnicity and culture. Joining me to the stage is, I keep saying stage, is Akindele. He is of the NABA, Michigan Council of Corps. He's coming to the stage right now.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. You know, I don't need to stand behind here. I'd like to talk to you this morning. Good morning. How's everybody going?
Good.
So my name is Akindele Akinyemi. I am the national co-director of the National African Business Association. We are based in Inkster, Michigan. We've been around for 3 years. We have chapters not just here in the state of Michigan, but also in Houston, Texas, which we successfully launched 2 weeks ago. Give ourselves a hand. And a chapter in the D.C., Maryland, and Virginia area. Guess what? What we do is very simple. It's to empower African-based businesses. Now, what does that mean? Do we empower the brand shops? Do we empower the local African markets? Of course we do. But we have a unique thing that we're doing. It's not just sending people from the United States to Africa to do business. That's okay. But we also want to bring African-based businesses back to the United States to empower local communities. And that is what we work on 24 hours, 7 days a week. Now, we're based in the city of Inkster. We sit on 5 wards in the city of Inkster. I am the chairman of the Inkster Downtown Development Authority. If you're looking to do business in the city of Inkster, come talk to me directly. I can open the door for you. I can feed you. We can go drink together. We can do whatever. But I guarantee you, I can help you open a business in the city of Inkster. Inkster Economic Development Corporation, I sit on the library board as well. We do need to empower our young people in terms of literacy, in terms of turning the ship around to make an Inkster a powerhouse city once again. Local Business Advisory Committee, and last but not least, the Tax Increment Finance Authority. We sit on those boards for a reason. It's because we position ourselves to attract new businesses to the city of Inkster. And the reality is what we're doing out there is remarkable. I mean, these things are very historic and epic on many proportions. Inkster Ignite, that is the technology incubator we're working on right now. Inkster Ignite to create a cyber city. Cybersecurity, everybody knows what's going on with cybersecurity, but how many people are talking about using cybersecurity as an anchor in terms of economic development to rebuild and revitalize urban communities right here in the state of Michigan? That's what we're working on right now. You understand? Agricultural and renewable technology, global education, guess what? Our partner school, Pathways Global Learning Academies, that's our partner school with NABA, part of our Global Education Zone. We will be opening September 5th. We invite everybody in the room. That's Miss Sophia Gibson. She's in the house. She has been working very hard. And yes, I'm giving her a shout out on live television because people who are watching this, I have a lot of Nigerians watching this right now. That's why we're streaming live. This is called a Michigan Trade Summit. We're talking about global business. So I have my folks in Nigeria. Oh, by the way, I forgot to tell you, we do have a Nigerian chapter in Abuja, and they're watching this right now. So what I'm saying, in a nutshell, we have a lot of things going on in global education, agriculture, renewable technology, STEM, cultural arts. Mr. Paul Carr, part of Detroit RAF, he is working very hard to develop a cultural arts district for us in the city of Inkster. And finally, micro enterprises for women empowerment. Now, anybody that knows me in person, know that I am for women empowerment. If you see me on Facebook or social media, this is all I talk about, is promoting women businesses and women empowerment. And the reason for that is because I strongly believe that women deserve, need, and must be given the opportunity to empower themselves and empower the communities around them to create a legacy and inheritance for the generations to come. So I'm very passionate about that, but I'm not gonna take up too much time because I can be here forever and a day. But the National African Business Association is on the move. We have a great team not just here locally, but nationally. We have a great team. Dr. Sherri Henderson is one of our board members, and we have some great, phenomenal board members that are actually, some board members will sit back, you need to do this. No, we have all our board members are hands-on. And so, we are a very active organization. We look forward to connecting and partnering with you. We look forward to partnerships and collaborations so that we can move the process even further down the road so we can all win at the end of the day. Once again, my name is Akindele Akinyemi. I'm the National Co-Director of the National African Business Association. Let's have fun, let's educate ourselves, and let's make it happen. Let's go.
That's just amazing, some of the work that you're doing, just amazing. That's right. Brent University, that's amazing. All right, we're gonna get started with our